Charis TV.
I have the grace. You can't stop me.
Then Jesse called Abinadab and made him pass before Samuel, and he said, neither hath Jehovah chosen this. Then Jesse made Shammah to pass by, and he said, neither hath Jehovah chosen this. And Jesse made seven of his sons to pass before Samuel, and Samuel said unto Jesse, Jehovah hath not chosen this. 11. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all thy children? And he said, there remaineth yet the youngest. And behold, he is keeping the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down until he come hither. 12. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and godly look to look upon. And Jehovah said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Amen. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of Jehovah came mightily upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want us to read with Amplified Bible, verse 12.
Verse 12 says, so Jesse sent word and brought him in. Now he had a ruddy complexion with beautiful eyes and a handsome appearance. The Lord said to Samuel, arise, anoint him, for this is he.
Yes.
Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed David in the presence of his brothers, and the Spirit of the Lord came mighty upon David from that day forward, and Samuel arose and went to Ramah.
I want you to look at this verse also.
Verse 6. It says, so it happens, when they had come, he looked at Eliab, the eldest son, and thought, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance or at the height of his stature, because I have rejected him. For the Lord sees not as man sees.
Yes, I want us to look on these two people. The firstborn and the lastborn. Here we can read about Samuel, who was already old in the prophetic ministry.
But still,
Samuel was also affected as we are. He was very old. He started to prophesy when he was a young man. And the Bible says when he reached to Jesse's house, the elders of the village, the elders of the village, they trembled because they know that he used to speak whatever he speaks come to pass. But if you read, the Bible says, after they trembled, they ask him, did you come here with peace? Or with judgment? They were afraid. He said, I've come here peaceably. In other words, I'm here to make peace.
kamantjwa mwe kitele moto dia khotso.
So now the problem starts.
Bototo batho botata batho motaelele.
He was a man.
Na le motho ba monna.
That after God has spoken with him.
Wa re kamra wa re modimo ba bolele ka yena.
He will speak it as it is.
But that
day there was a test.
Because all
of us, we have to go through
that test. He
looked at
Eliab.
He said, surely this man
is the one
that God has anointed. But if you read about Eliab, the
Bible says,
it shows God has tried Eliab.
Because
he said, don't look at him, I've rejected
him. No.
Meaning before God sent Samuel in
Jesus' house, he might
have tried all the boys in the
village.
And found they are not fit to be leaders. And therefore, when people are looking around, but they were just choosing each
other.
Even Samuel.
Le Samuel.
He said, Eliab is fit to
lead. But God said,
don't even look at
him. I have
gone with him from where
he is.
To the end.
He won't
be fit to be
a leader.
Remember when God chose David,
he said, he wanted
a man after his
heart.
God is the creator.
He
knows all our
hearts.
He traveled with you
throughout your years. He
knows what will happen
10 years to come. He
knows what will happen the rest of
your life. That's why
you are the way you are today.
That is why you are the way you
are today. He has
tried Eliab.
He even went to Shama. But when he looked at the last boy,
he
said, this one is fit to be anointed to be a king. Amen.
Amen.
So listen to this. We can make a lot of mistakes if we don't find God's interpretation.
That's
right, God's interpretation. We can make very serious mistakes if we don't find God's interpretation. The interpretations from God makes us to fulfill His purpose. By the time of Jesus, Jesus was troubled by people who cannot
discern.
And many times they made foolish decisions. Think about if Samuel might have anointed
Eliab.
The Spirit of the Lord will not come. Because after he anointed David, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him and moved with him forward.
You know,
I was beginning to ask myself, how many people we are anointing? Because many, they are not fit for that anointing. And the Spirit of the Lord will never come upon
them.
We are in always wrong assignments.
Because
whoever interpret according to God's interpretation is always being aligned with God to fulfill His purpose. for example, let me give an example.
So pasire ke le feng yone.
Let's take you look at someone.
Are re motho mongwe lebeletse motho mongwe.
And you find she's beautiful.
Wa re ha o lebella wa bona gore ke mo botse.
And you marry.
Wa munyala.
And the person become your wife.
Motho aba mosadi wa go ba molekane wa.
What will happen to you?
O tata bo dialang ka wena.
Can you see if we don't find God's interpretation?
Wa bona o sanya ke thaloso ya modimo.
We will have wrong wives.
Re tla ba le basadi ba seng bona.
We will be in wrong churches.
Re tla ba ka ra dikereke tse di seng tsona.
We will work wrong jobs.
Re tla shuma le mishomo e mengwe e seng yona.
We will be in wrong business.
Re tla tsena ka ra di business tse di seng tsona.
Whatever we are doing wrong.
Ka mo ka tere re di yang di no ba di
post. God is not involved.
Modimo ha yo ka ra di taba tsa
ona. The spirit of the Lord is not there.
Maiwa modimo le yona ha yo ana mo.
If God is not involved.
Ha modimo a si sa tsa le maiwa modimo a o a o tsene mo
I don't know if you're hearing.
Ake tsebale ntwa.
As somebody says.
Botsa motho leng gaofe.
Are you asking God on what you are seeing?
O botsa modimo na mo di ntung tse o di bonang.
Or you are just taking as it is.
O ba o no tsha di taba di le ka mogodi leng ka ona wa tswala pele.
Let's ask God for interpretation.
Nge nge re botsa modimo a tare thalosetse.
I can give you an example in the Genesis.
Nka le fa mathala mo la bokeng ya Genesis.
From the beginning.
O to wa mathomong.
When Satan came to Adam and Eve.
A Satan e a ita wa Adam le Eva.
Satan gave his own interpretation.
Satan o ile a taka thaloso ya hae.
And the woman looked at the tree.
Mosadi a ta lebelela mothare.
And see that the tree is worthy to produce a fruit that can be eaten.
O ta le di enyo tse di ka jiwang.
Whereas the interpretation of God was.
Ka mo khanti thaloso ya Modimo le ile ya hore.
You are out of his presence.
A o tswai o jai o tswile boneng ba Modimo.
Yeah. Was you will have wisdom, you will be like God.
But
Satan could not say you will die.
Mara Satan has said, "Bulele yela ya
roto." Outside of God's presence.
Watawa pila kante abu gona ba mudimu.
Many of us today we are outside of God's presence by failing to find interpretations.
Kau palelo utola di taluso.
We eat, we die.
Raja rahwa.
If we read Matthew 20.
Araba la mula Matthew 20.
We read from verse
20.
We see two sons of Zebedee. We see two sons of what?
Zebedee.
These sons were intelligent.
After
they found that Jesus is Messiah, they knew that Jesus is going to be a king.
But Jesus ina re tswela pelo taba khosi.
But they lack to understand.
Jano mara ba palo
kushisha. Being a king.
Ore taba khosi ya mofuta mang.
The Bible says.
Bible re.
They spoke with their mom.
Ba bolela ka melomo ya bona.
As a mama.
Ba re mama.
That man is going to be a king.
Mona la uto ba khosi se khale.
But if we ask by our own.
Mara jano nga re ka ikhupelela.
He can deny or the disciple will fight us.
Mama,
let's go with you. You speak on our behalf. They discuss together. Mama agreed.
Mama dumela.
I'm seeing them. Mama is walking in front. And they were following. Today is today. Another one was saying, if I will sit on the left, I will sit on the right.
They were
arguing with their hearts. And now Mama reached
Jesus.
And say, Lord Jesus. We know you are going to be a king. Can you allow my son to sit on the left? Another one on the right. Jesus said,
Shem.
It's not me to give that. Because even me, I'm here to serve. And after I finish serving, the one who sent me must judge me. So the kingdom that I'm supposed to be is not over here. It's after we are dead here. Can you tell
everybody,
say, the kingdom
that
we are going to is not of here. So Jesus said, we will serve God.
Yeah.
I mean, you serve God, you will suffer here. But the one who decides to put on the right and the left is the one called
Jehovah.
I don't know if you're hearing that. They fail to understand that here we are here to serve. They thought here it was over. And they forget they were born here. It means they are supposed to die here. I don't know if you're hearing me. If you want to read Hebrews 12:2, you hear Jesus say there was a joy that was set before him. And this makes him to endure the cross, despising the shame. And God made him to sit on the right hand of the Father. Listen to this. If you people, you won't have good interpretation of what you see, you will fight your heaven here. And you miss the heaven above. Jesus in Hebrews 12:2, he said, the Bible says he's the author and the finisher of our faith. Meaning that we must copy him. Despise the challenges he went through. He despised the shame. He went through tough times and experienced the
challenge
because of the joy that was set before him. In fact, he was there. He understood shame, but he could see beyond the shame. If we can be Christians like
Jesus,
we won't worry about the blessing of the world. Because look at Jesus, who came to be shamed. They naked him. I mean, he had all authority. Changing everything. He suffered. But he could see beyond that suffering. When he said, Elo, Elo,
Elo, lama sabachthani,
he was seeing sins everywhere.
Na bona dibi di aparetse lefase ka moka.
And he could not see the face of God. He was saying, I'm seeing everything, but I still need you, God. I can see darkness, but I need you, God. Sometimes we need to have interpretations of our darkness, so that we seek God more and search for him, than to go and ask God always why I'm facing all this, why I'm challenged, why I'm troubled. If you find out, you will enjoy in the midst of tribulation. There are some things, Christians, you don't need to pray to change them. Some prayers you're offering to change them is because you are limited to understand what will follow after that. Therefore, you will spend time fasting and crying, asking God why all this. So Jesus, in that verse, can we just read verse 2, the whole verse 2? Say what?
Verse 2. Looking away from all that will distract us and focusing our eyes on Jesus, who is the author and the perfecter of our faith, the first incentive for our belief, and the one who brings our faith to maturity, who for the joy of the accomplishing the goal set before him endures the cross, disregarding the shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God, revealing his deity, his authority, and the completion of his work.
Listen, Jesus completed his work. And Jesus is not standing on the right, he is sitting. To show that he has done his job. And
he
is glorified. So, can you just read the first stanza of that verse?
Looking away from all the will, looking away from all that will distract us.
Stop there. Looking away from all that will distract you. Because whatever you are going through is temporary. You need to have interpretation. Looking away. Tell me, but look away. Take your eyes away from whatever that will distract you. If you read this verse, Hebrews
5,
from verse 8 to 9,
from 8 and 9,
I want us to look at that verse clearly and see what Jesus did. He look away and become perfect. Read, Mama.
Verse 8.
Yes.
Although he was a son
Who
had never been disobedient to the Father.
Start again, Mama.
Although he was a son.
Though he was a son.
Who had never been disobedient to the Father.
Listen to that. Though he was a son who never disobeyed his Father. Okay?
He learned.
He learned.
Active special obedience through what he suffered.
He learned obedience through what he suffered.
And having been made perfect.
After that, God made him perfect.
Uniquely equipped and prepared as Savior and retaining his integrity amid opposition. Amen. He became the source of eternal salvation. An eternal inheritance to all those who obey him.
You know, here you can understand that Jesus suffered. And you understand what the Bible says in Matthew 5,
verse 11 and 12,
that you are also blessed if people make you suffer. Jesus suffered too. These things that you people are crying for, of the blessing, houses, cars, whatever, these things are not normal. Look beyond that. Jesus suffered. He learned obedience. And this makes him to be complete.
Perfect.
He suffering makes him
to obey.
I'll tell you what another thing that happened to Jesus.
It's not written in the Bible.
Before Jesus became matured, his father died. When Joseph died, because he was eldest,
he's
supposed to do the job of his father.
And
he could not do it perfect. And to be a carpenter was not an easy job. And now, look here. What makes Jesus to go and pray was because of that. He said, no, I'm doing this. This is not my job. I have to consult the customers of my father. I have to do my father's job. Look here. When you grow up, you need to be better than your father. I don't know if you're hearing me. So what makes Jesus to say, no, this is not what I'm here for? Look here, when you can't do the job like your father. He might have gone to one customer. And the customer say, no, you know the way you're doing. So he might have suffered too much. So the Bible says he learned obedience.
So Bible by suffering.
He saw suffering. And that suffering promoted him to another level. Allow suffering to bring God's interpretation. Allow shame to bring God's interpretation. Allow lowliness to bring God's interpretation. If you want to see, look at Hannah, who was failing to give birth, to extend that she have to face the man of God. Whereas God was preparing her to give birth to a prophet. Whatever is hard to produce, need your wisdom from God.
Remember,
whatever is hard to produce, it needs wisdom from God. If you see some people are successful,
you're failing.
No, God is telling me, rely on me. You need my interpretation. See things the way I see them. Because listen, when other people are achieving things their way, tell yourself you are not supposed to do them their way. Remember, on God's purpose, our thoughts are not His thoughts. Even His ways are not our ways. So if you are failing on your way, ask God is interpretation. He will guide you. And you will be successful. I see you being successful. I see God opening your way. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
So Jesus suffered. This thing reminds me that when I started ministry, I spent 6 months. Before I start, just going to pray in the bush. And then from there, I found that in that 6 months, I lost everything I had. And from there, I began to rely on the issue of, if I want to serve God, I must see beyond things. But if I have to look on things, I will lose all. Because sometimes God wants to deal with us in our pride to obey Him. He wants to deal with us with our stance so that we shifted to God's opinion. But if we are still maintaining our ego, we are bound to make mistakes. I don't know if you're hearing me. In the process of losing, I began to enjoy to seek Him. Every morning, 4 o'clock, I'll move away. Past 9. I'm coming back. And this has helped me a lot. Because listen to me. You will never be in God's preparation until you find God's interpretations. The moment you look at your situation, and you find you still have answers of it, God will never prepare you for you for anything.
Modimo ka tswa o lukisheli tse silo.
You will search for God.
O to munyaka eng?
When you see that there my power is failing.
A o bona re mo matanga ka ke sa gona ke palela.
And it's only God who can honor.
Ana ke modimo yena a le tee ya ka o fang.
Let me show you this scripture
to. Re ke le bontsheng le ngwalo le le tla le thusha.
In Luke 12.
Luke 12.
49.
Luke 12:49.
Let's read that verse. As somebody says, what kind of interpretation are you getting out of your situation? What is the interpretation? It might be saying, seek me more. Just read that verse 49. Yes.
I have come to cast fire, judgment on the earth, and how I wish that it were already kindled.
Carry on. 50.
I have a baptism of great suffering with which to be baptized, and how greatly I distressed until it is accomplished. Do you suppose that I came to grant peace on earth? No, I tell you, but rather division between believers and unbelievers. For from now on, five in one household will be divided over me, three against two and two against three. They will be divided, father against son, and son against father, mother against daughter, and daughter against mother, mother-in-law against daughter-in-law, and daughter-in-law against mother-in-law. He also said to the crowds, when you see a cloud rising in the west, you immediately say it is going to rain, and that is how it turns out. And when you see that a south wind is blowing, you say it will be a hot day, and it happens. You hypocrites, play action and pretenders. You know how to analyze and intelligently interpret and appearance of the earth and sky to forecast the weather. But why do you not intelligently interpret this present time? And why do you not even on your own initiative judge what is right? For while you are going with your openness at law to appear before a magistrate on the way, make an effort to settle so that he does not drag you before the judge, and the judge does not rule against you and turn you over to the officer, and the officer does not throw you into prison. I say to you, you absolutely will not get out of three of there until you have paid the very last cent.
Here Jesus was teaching people how to live with people around them. How to live with people around you. You are about to see some characters from people. You are about to see people of your family standing against
you.
If truly you have got God's interpretation, you won't be affected in your holiness. Many people were offending each other. Family functions.
Malfunction jamalapa.
Beating each other, accusing each other. Jesus said, I have come here to bring fire.
So Jesus ra abalela thalosa rena ke tile mo o to tisa mollo.
these two can be against
this will stand with this one.
So the moment you see that,
so
your Christianity cannot be affected by
anybody
in your family. He was worried, he said, I'm surprised people, they know how to discern the wind, but they are failing to discern their brother. You know, this is the time that now we need to be able to discern Christians in the church. Here you can see Jesus was speaking that people here, it might be meaning something to us according to gospel
interpretations.
If truly you are a Christian, you can find the interpretation of God, how they live with you, by the way people live with you. Because if they reject you, it means God is accepting you. If they fight you, it means God is with you. But you cannot fight back. Because the Bible says, I have not come here to make peace. There have to be a battle, but you must be able to fight God's interpretation. It happens to Jesus. The whole family were saying, Jesus is mad. And one day, you know, one woman says, blessed is the womb that has carried you. But Jesus says more than that. Blessed is the one who hears the word. Jesus said, whoever hears the word and do it is my brother and my sister. I don't know if you hear me. Many of you are affected by the actions of people and what people are saying. You need to find God's interpretation.
Look,
today, you are in a wrong side because of the wrong story you have been given. Today, you are fighting wrong people because you cannot hear from God. If you find wrong interpretation, you are bound to behave that way. And this can make you to sin. You are not different with the one who's interpreting you. Tell
me,
but you are not different with the one who's interpreting to you. If God interprets, you are one with him. If Satan interprets, you are one with him. Tell you, you are not different with the one who's interpreting to you. That is why today, faith is going down. Why? Because we don't find God's interpretation. Someone will just come and tell you, that one is wicked. And you conclude, yes. It's true, that person is wicked. When you hear stories against someone, just say it suits your calling. Or it suits his life. Can you tell him, I say, hey, I want interpretation of what you are telling me. But what you are telling me, it suits him. But I will ask from God. If we can have Christians like that, we won't sing with our tongues. Because we are spending time trying to define the destinies of others, not knowing that it's only God who designed them
and
destined them. We need to know God's opinion. God's interpretation. Why your life is like this?
Why you
are challenged by this?
Why when I challenge you,
the moment you find it,
you
can rejoice in pain. You can see solution in darkness. You can see beyond the curtains of
time.
But if not, you'll compare yourself with others. Why my things are like this? Others are like that. Accept yourself. You
are
being challenged the more because of the destiny that has been set before you. You are going through what you are going through because it's God's plan for you. See beyond the challenge. See beyond the shame. See beyond the attack. See beyond the sickness. See beyond what you are going through. And God of mercy will see you through. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Can you tell everybody, see beyond? I want to show you something that I was reading this morning.
This,
I always read it because I'm doing a missionary work.
In Acts 16
from verse 6. Can you just read that verse there?
Now they passed through the territory of Phrygia and Galatia after being forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in the west coast province of Asia Minor. And after they came to Mysia, they tried to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not permit them. So passing by Mysia, they went down to Troas. Then a vision appeared to Paul in the night. A man from the Roman province of Macedonia was standing and pleading with him, saying, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." And when he had seen the vision, we, including Luke, tried to go on into Macedonia at once, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them.
Can you hear that? These people, they have got Holy Spirit. The Bible says when they try to move, Holy Spirit denied them. They came to Mysia and they want to go to Bithynia.
Now,
the Bible says the Spirit of Jesus denied them. These people might have seen the vision of Jesus, say, "Don't go there." The first thing here was the Spirit, Holy Spirit, whisper to their ear, "Don't enter there." But here, the Bible said the Spirit of Jesus. In other words, the Spirit of Jesus appeared and said,
"Hey,
don't go to Bithynia." But Paul dreamed a dream. He saw a man of
Macedonia.
You know, you could hear these people there, good interpretation. The moment you see a man say, "Come this side and
the Bible
says they sailed, they went there same time. And they agree it's God who's sending us. You know, this is has been my lesson every day. That there are places where even when we are anointed, we are not supposed to go. There are invitations we are not supposed to honor. We need God to give us his interpretation. What was left, if now Holy Spirit speaks, and the Spirit of Jesus speaks, we need interpretation. Now. We need to know what's going on. We need God's connection to here. If not, we'll be busy with things that God is not involved. One time, I said, "God must help us." Because even the way now we prophesy, I don't think it's what God wants us to do. Because those people, when they do that, always was to bring people to Jesus. Was not to catch them to themselves. I don't know if you're hearing me. Was not to catch them to make them to follow them. Me, because I've been traveling. I found people who are weary in their spirit. Others were told, sow a seed, this will happen. Others were told, within 3 months, God is telling me now. God is telling me now, 3 months now.
Or
1 week you'll be pregnant. And I realized that we need God's interpretation. If not, we affect the younger ones. There are some people now, they don't trust any servant of God. Because they have been told things and waited, nothing happened. Even us, we Christians, we need God interpretation concerning the servants of God. Otherwise, we're not supposed to be robbed and lied to. Otherwise, we're not supposed to be told things which are not even there. I don't know if you're hearing me. Pastor, I need God's interpretation. If we found God's interpretation about our situation, are we still going to ask for prophecy? If we found it, are we still going to be robbed? If not, prophecy is important for you today. Because you want to know what will happen. I'm sure you're hearing me. But if you found it, are you still going to complain? I still going to fast. I still going to ask you to thank God about your situation. Because you know God is about to change that situation. I don't know if you're hearing me. I see you thanking God about your situation. And God wants to change that situation. I just want to speak these two things. And I close. Go and read John 13. Go and read the whole chapter. And see how Judas was given a chance to repent. When Jesus was saying, one person among you will betray you. And everybody was asking each other, who's that? Who's that? And Judas was like,
Judas was like this.
Because Judas was supposed to have asked, how does he know? Jesus ended up saying, the betrayer, it's going to be worse for him. It is better if he was not born. Jesus was speaking. That betrayer was better if he was not born.
He was waiting for 30 pieces of silver.
It's like I'm seeing Judas. He was speaking in tongues. And others are asking each other, is it you? Judas was relaxed. This guy, I know he will escape. If they catch him, as long as I have this money,
if they catch him, you will escape.
Jesus said, you know what? This person is not even born. The second thing Jesus said, okay, he took a bread and said, the one that I will give him. And then
and
this person is the one that will betray
Judas.
Judas open his mouth
like,
and the mouth
I don't know who cooked this.
This person is the best cooker. And
the
Bible says Satan entered him.
Satan kana
the moment when he swallowed that,
kana kwa meja, Satan
entered him.
Satan
and Jesus said, hey,
yes, sorry.
What you want to do?
Nyawo se ula una kongo sitira.
Do it quickly. He said, okay, I'm going to do it.
Can you
just see the missing of interpreting?
There are
some people you never change them.
Even you sit down with them,
please,
this thing will
kill
you. This thing
is wrong.
What you are doing,
they will know
as long as
there's a pieces of silver. You can try everything. You cannot
change Judas.
I don't know if you're hearing me. You could not change Judas. When other people were asking each other, he was speaking in tongues. After his eating, when he was busy chewing, looking around, after
his shallow,
the Bible says he went into the dark.
He went to the,
and he disappeared. And he went there and said, guys, Jesus, when you finish eating there, I was eating with him. You people organize my money. So I'll check you where he is. You can't change
Judas.
But you must understand the interpretation of
Judas.
When Jesus saw
Judas,
he said, my friend. Think about Jesus looking at Judas and calling
Judas
friend. Why have you come this way? Jesus was excited that Judas was doing his job. Because otherwise he could not go to the cross. So he said,
oh,
my friend, you are coming here to lift me. Because listen to this. If you know the interpretations of your enemies, you'll be excited and you won't call them enemy, you'll call them friends. Because they are there, they are working for good, they are uplifting you. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
I see your friend lifting you. I see your enemy lifting you. You are not supposed to worry when your friends rise against you and they become enemies. God is using them. I
say
God is using them. I say God is using them. If it was you, I'm sure you were supposed to be angry. You were supposed even to reveal to this one. Peter, come here.
Petro,
Judas is the one who's
going
to be James.
James,
you know that Judas is the one.
Judas,
okay, Bartholomew, come
Bartholomew
here.
Bartholomew,
do you know
Judas?
And by the time when they are sitting, when Jesus said, one of you is going to betray, all of them, they were supposed to be knowing. They were supposed to be looking like this.
Judas.
But Jesus made it secret because he had interpretation. If you have got interpretation, no one will fight because of you. I say no one will fight because of you. Everything will work for good. I see breakthrough in your life. I see success in your life.
Keep watching Charis TV.
Thank you.